we just had a big family gathering for one of our younger cousins who just graduated from University of Illinois. And had a wonderful time.
It was just before 10 o'clock last night when 84-year-old Verona Gunn was riding home from that family function with her daughter, son-in-law, and his 9-year-old daughter. They were sitting at the stoplight at Laramie and Division when this happened. Chicago police say they were responding to a call of officers needing assistance when a marked police van and unmarked police SUV crashed into each other in the intersection, hitting 3 other vehicles, including Dwight Gunn's sister's blue Toyota sedan.
That unmarked vehicle actually flipped over my sister's car. Both airbags deployed. My sister has burns on her shoulder. Unfortunately, they did not properly, in my mind, assess my mother, who had dementia, and probably because she could not tell them what was hurting.
Verona Gunn was transported to Community Hospital on Addison. Once she was there, her son says doctors realized she was in critical condition with internal bleeding. Not equipped to handle that level of trauma, they transported her to Illinois Masonic Hospital, where Gunn says she arrived around 1 a.m., but it was too late.
There was at least 2 different places she was bleeding from, and when they went to try to address one issue, they identified a second issue with regard to where she was bleeding, and it was just, her heart just couldn't take it.
Dwight Gunn, a pastor in Austin, wants accountability after losing his elderly mother, the matriarch of his family.
Just a dynamic woman who was loving and caring. She helped anyone she could. Family's hurting is still very much a shock to us, and hopefully we will get some answers that will be satisfactory.
Dwight Gunn still has lots of questions for Chicago police on their protocol to responding to calls and how these officers didn't realize their paths were crossing in that intersection. 2 of the 10 officers taken to the hospital last night are still there being treated. The other passengers in the car that Verona Gunn was riding in are all released from the hospital and going to be okay.